I'm Dr. Mark Joffe. I'm an infectious diseases specialist. I've been working here in Edmonton for the last nearly 30 years. Over that period of time, I've had roles in infection prevention and control, and really importantly, I've had a role in workplace health and safety. So for the last 30 years, it's been my role to protect healthcare workers from catching infections in their line of work. So we've been monitoring the international situation very closely, and we are guided by recommendations that come out of agencies such as the World Health Organization, and in particular the Public Health Agency of Canada. They issue guidance about how to protect healthcare workers. We know that this microbe is spread mostly through droplets at close range or through direct contact with unclean hands. We also know that droplet and contact precautions are effective at preventing infection. So that means gloves and a gown. It means a mask, a surgical mask or procedure mask for most activities, and it means eye protection. Protecting our staff is our number one priority. This equipment that we are recommending will protect staff. So our CPSEM procurement team have been active from the first moments that COVID-19 began to be reported. They recognized that we would be needing additional supplies. They will continue to bring in supply over the next several months as we need it. We want to be sure that our healthcare workers have what they need at the front lines, at the bedside, and we will do everything we can to ensure that our healthcare workers have what they need to protect themselves, because safety of our staff is our number one priority. We are seeing an increasing demand for N95 respirators, and they are important to use in specific situations. For most contact with patients who have COVID-19 or who have possible COVID-19, a surgical or a procedure mask is perfectly adequate because it protects against those droplets that might be generated by that patient. When performing specific procedures that we call aerosol-generating medical procedures, things like an intubation, an extubation, or open suctioning, then it's important to go to the N95 respirator. It needs to be fit tested so that an individual knows which one to use and then is fit checked every time it's donned. These devices provide additional protection from small particle aerosols that can be generated at close range when those sorts of medical procedures are being performed. Again, protecting our staff is our number one priority, and we provide N95 fit-tested masks or respirators for those situations. That's an important question that we are asked quite a bit right now. We don't recommend that members of the public routinely wear masks. They provide no benefit when they're worn continuously day after day. Now, when they might be useful is if an individual develops symptoms, particularly a fever or a cough, and they're presenting to a healthcare setting for assessment, then it would be helpful if they have access to a mask to don that mask. It blocks those droplets that spread virus right at the source, and they can be very useful. However, most of the time for day in, day out activity, wearing of a mask is not necessary. Social distancing, keeping 2 meters apart, and frequent hand hygiene are the optimal strategies. Well, the first thing I would say is that protecting our staff is our number one priority. Secondly, I think it's only natural in this time for individuals to feel concerned, to feel worried. They're concerned about themselves, they're concerned about their loved ones, their family. I think that's only natural. But I'll reiterate again that protecting our staff is absolutely our number one priority. We are providing the personal protective equipment that we know works. There is ample experience around the world now to know that this equipment works. The key is it needs to be used, and it needs to be used properly. It's about that precision of putting that equipment on and in particular, precision at taking it off so that we don't self-contaminate ourselves with unclean hands as we take our equipment off. Protection of our frontline workers is our number one priority. Well, the first thing I would want to emphasize is that staff should stay home if they are unwell. If they're sick, stay home. Aside from that, there are some routine measures that we can all do to help protect ourselves during this time. We talk a lot about hand hygiene, but it really does work. Clean your hands often with soap and water or alcohol hand sanitizer. Avoid touching your face, your eyes, your nose, your mouth with unclean hands. Try to maintain that social distance when out in public. In other words, 2 meters or 6 feet away from other individuals. And high touch surfaces at home or in the workplace should be cleaned and should be disinfected using the recommended products. So I would encourage staff to check the Insight website. There's lots of good, useful, current information. It's updated constantly. I just want to end by saying these are tough times, but we're in this together. We are going to support each other, and we will get through this together.